I guess I consider myself a Renaissance man. I kind of just do everything that's interesting to me. I used to be an economist. I'm sort of a reformed economist. Right now, we're working on a lot of stuff looking at graphs. So trying to understand how human brains process graphs, because there's almost no information about that. We know a lot about faces, we know a lot about words, but people don't do graphs. And then, because I'm a director here at the TTNI, I work with a lot of other people and help them try to figure out what they need to do and how to do their own research. So everything from looking at plants, to looking at Alzheimer's patients, to actually looking at fashion. So there's a lot of projects that I sort of help with. People use graphs in a lot of different ways to communicate with each other. The idea is that you can communicate more instinctively with people, but it's not clear that that's true. I think people all around the globe are going to use this, and it would be nice if they knew which graphs to use to communicate the actual information they want to communicate. As a director of the TTNI, I get to work with a lot of people. The whole director's job is basically service. So I go out and meet with other people. So yesterday I was meeting with people from health sciences. We're trying to figure out how to use certain technologies to look at Alzheimer's and look at early detection of Alzheimer's. I'm trying to get something so that we can bring some kids in here and have them get a chance to, like, maybe not for science project, but become interested in science and say, oh, this would be sort of a cool thing. So I would like to be able to get some kids and say, what would you like to see in this scanner? You know, what would be of interest to you? So I think that would be a good outreach thing to encourage people to study science. A colleague of mine, I'm paraphrasing him, maybe not perfectly, but he says there's no excuse for bad teaching. So you want to do a good job at that, because, you know, these kids came from around here. I mean, when I first got here, I showed up here, I grew up in Carlsbad, and I looked at these kids and I said, you know, these people look just like I did 20 years ago, or however many years ago it was, sitting in this classroom trying to learn something. So you got to do good teaching. But research is sort of what gets you up in the morning, and how you contribute and can leave sort of a lasting mark. So you've got to strive to do that as much as possible. I mean, it should be fun, right? I mean, Monday morning is usually my favorite day of the week because I get to go back and do stuff. You know, sometimes it's a meeting, so it's not my favorite day of the week. But in general, favorite day of the week will be Monday. So you got to do research that you like and enjoy. I think professors are curious people, and they just say, hey, I wonder what would happen if we did this. Hopefully they have a little oversight so they don't hurt anyone, but you know, what would happen if you put a pumpkin in a scanner or M&M's in a scanner? You know, if you got the opportunity, you might as well go to do that.